Is this a war?
I think it's a fight, a battle that we're fighting.
Seashore comes out and patrols with permission of the Mexican government. We come out in the night and drift in an area that's supposed to be completely protected. They're casting their nets illegally. There's no fishing allowed at night. We go there and we just motor towards them.
Why are they fleeing?
Well, poachers will flee when they're caught.
One by one, Sea Shepherd's drone catches poachers in the act. At daybreak, evidence of their crime surfaces.
This is the net, but look what was trapped here. This is the fish that we're talking about, the Totoaba. Its bladder is the merchandise.
This is a fresh swim bladder of a Totoaba fish.
The swim bladder keeps the Totoaba afloat. But in China, like rhino horn and elephant ivory, Totoaba bladder is sold on the black market for its supposed medicinal and anti-aging benefits. Poachers make as much money from bladders as they do from smuggling cocaine. Profepa, Mexico's Environmental Protection Agency, showed us the $750,000 haul from a recent bust.
Who's trafficking these bladders?
En un método hormiga, la llevan oculta en vehículos, en maletas, en refrigeradores y hieleras, hasta ciudades fronterizas por conducto de Estados Unidos o directo, Hong Kong, Shanghai.
Under Hong Kong law, selling Totoaba bladder is illegal. But that doesn't stop it. This shop owner claiming he didn't have any on hand, showing us photos of dried Totoaba bladder. And estimated this large one costs $100,000. It's the best of the best, he says. It will make you more beautiful.
Is it possible that the fishermen could have their pathway as extensive as this without the cartel's help?
Es obvio que existen grupos organizados para llevar a cabo el trasiego a otro país de este tipo de productos. Es obvio.
We spent the day here in San Felipe talking to fishermen. Now, none of them wanted to go on camera, but they all told us the same thing. They want to fish for Totoaba. They know it's out there. They know the environmental problems, but they still want to because they know how much they could make. They feel like they're being punished by the government. This was removed from the fish 5 days ago.
The Mexican military's operation to stop poachers rivals their counter-narcotics effort.
Busca.
With retrained canine dogs to pick up the scent of Totoaba contraband.
Muy bien, Atlas, muy bien.
And on their daily air patrols, they find nearly a dozen of these giant illegal nets a day.
La cabeza y entonces.
So the head swims through here.
Sí, y ya al momento de quererse regresar, aquí es donde.
Can't get out.
Donde traba el animal.
Trapped. If a couple of species die in this one little bay, why should anyone care?
That's a good question. The whole ecosystem is really what we're looking at. We're not looking at protecting just a vaquita or just a Totoaba, but you need all those little parts to make the whole system work. And if the whole system doesn't work, we're part of the system. So it eventually affects us as well.
This is the end of the line. What they've done is cut that large net in half. This is a half they've been able to pull up.
It's just another one of those lies that people consume, and it's not, you know, healthy for them, and it's definitely not healthy for the oceans.